We made it. We made it to 500, and you know what that means.
Rap Devil featuring, not featuring, it's featuring by Machine Gun Kelly. And then after that, we're going to do Breakdown Killshot by Eminem. But Rap Devil was first, so let's just...
I hope you're excited.
I'm going to give up, and I'm just going to say, let's just get to it.
Oh, shit. Let's okay, get to it. We deserve it. Okay, let's do it.
Grab some clippers, this fucking beard is weird. Tough talk from a rapper paying me for security a year. I think my dad's gone. Yeah, Haley, you right. Dad's always mad, cooped up in the studio, yelling at the mic. You sober and bored, huh? I know, I'm about to be 46 years.
Yo, okay, first of all, I kind of like the sample a lot.
Like the guitar?
Like, yeah, the beginning, but as soon as the beat dropped, it switched. So I was like,
you like the beginning?
I like the bam, bam, bam,
bam, bam. Okay, something I want to talk about. Because we talked about this in our older videos as well. When you start a verse, you come at it with like hardest line.
Hot.
What did you think of somebody grab him some clippers? His fucking beard is weird.
Childish. That was fucking childish, bro.
Listen, we're going to give credit where credit's due. That first line was kind of...
so childish.
Like, kind of trash.
I would have said that in like elementary school.
Yeah, yeah. I do like the next line though, like about him paying millions for security a year. Yeah. It's like, oh, that's tough talk coming from you. That's a good bar, I thought.
MGK said some shit about his daughter, and then he...
Don't come after Haley.
Yeah, yeah, exactly. Ooh, ooh, ooh.
Yeah.
Who knows? Eminem said some shit about him on another song. Do you, like, and that's...
Not Alike?
Not Alike.
I think it was?
Yeah.
Yeah, because if you've heard Not Alike, he's talking about like I'm talking to you, Kelly. Like, keep commenting on my daughter, Haley. I'm gonna call up my boys. Like, we're gonna mess you up. So I think he's talking about like, oh, that's tough talk coming at me. Like,
exactly
paying millions for security a year. And then I also like My Dad's Gone Crazy is a song on the Eminem show. He brings that into the lyrics. Like, I like that concept where you're taking songs from his discography
and
like
using
the,
it
yeah. Oh, my dad's so cool. Gone crazy. Yeah, Haley, you're right.
There's actually like a scream in there.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay, and then he goes, dad's always mad, cooped up in the studio yelling at the mic.
Yeah, because a lot of people were saying that with Kamikaze, weren't they, where he's like, oh, you're
just mad. Yeah.
How the fuck Sourpuss
gonna get mad at us just because his album sucks? Yeah. So far, not a terrible start.
No, there's some bars there.
For paying me for security a year, I think my dad's gone. Yeah, Haley, you right. Dad's always mad, cooped up in the studio, yelling at the mic. You sober and bored, huh? I know, I'm about to be 46 years old, dog. Talk about, I'ma call up Trick. Man, you sound like a bitch. Man, I can handle your shit. Mad about something I said in 2012, took you 6 years and a surprise album just to come with a diss.
Okay. Man, going after sobriety.
Uh-oh.
You're sober and bored, huh? Like, you got nothing better to do now that you're not on drugs? Is Machine Gun Kelly do drugs? Probably.
I'm sure he does.
Probably.
I'm sure he
Fuck. He's also putting his age into it, like, about
he's
to be 46
old.
Years old, dog. This is what I was talking about, because Trick is like... Trick is apparently... I'm not from Detroit, but he's apparently like, when you go to Detroit, you don't like introduce yourself to the mayor. You introduce yourself to Trick. Like, he's like the kingpin of the city.
I'm calling up Trick.
He said it in Not Alike. He's like, oh, don't make me call up Trick. So this is like Machine Gun Kelly being like, oh, I'm going to call up Trick. Man, you sound like a bitch.
Yeah.
That's like, I don't know. When I listen to this, partially I'm cringing, but he's coming at him with some bars. I don't know if it's going to get stronger. I don't remember if there's like really hard bars. But you're digging your grave.
Yo! Like, that's another reason why I cringe. Because it's like, you know, he's not coming. Okay, if you're going to swing at the king, you better fucking kill the king. And he's not. He's not even doing anything.
Don't leave him alive. But when he's like, because Eminem's like, yo, I'm going to call it Trick. And he's like, oh, you're going to call it. You sound like a bitch. Ooh. It's like, bro.
Do you know what you're doing? Like, but you know what? I do like when he made Trick sound like bitch. And he's like, you sound like a bitch. Bitch.
Yeah.
That's cool.
One more thing I wanted to talk about is he's like mad about something I said in 2012. That's talking about what you said about him commenting on Haley's photo.
Yeah.
Was she underage at the time?
She was. I think she was 16.
Yeah.
And he was like 20 something.
Yeah. Yeah.
Or 20.
Yeah. But then he says it took you six years and a surprise album to come out with a diss. And he's talking about Kamikaze because he dissed him a couple of times.
Yo, I heard, based on this line specifically, I heard that that shit that he said about Haley didn't even like hit Eminem's radar until like years after anyway.
Really?
Yeah. So it's like, I feel like he would have said something sooner if he heard about it. sooner. Because I think he said it on an interview with Sway. Like, I didn't even fucking hear about that shit until afterwards. And then I heard he was, like, talking shit about me. And I was like, who are you? Who is this guy? You think I give a fuck about you saying anything about me?
Okay, so I just saw a picture. This isn't me saying this, by the way. I just want to quote, unquote. Okay, so I just saw a picture of Eminem's daughter, .. And I have to say, she is hot as fuck in the most respectable way possible because M is king.
Oof. Did you really have to say, though?
That's like...
Did you have to say? Was it a have to kind of thing?
Yeah. No. You didn't have to.
Nobody held a machine gun to your head.
Get out.
No. Don't go after his family, bro.
Yeah. Oh, man, yeah. And I believe he comes after Kim as well in this song, if I remember correctly. I remember. I won't skip ahead, but I think there's something about Kim in here. Have you seen the music video for this?
I have, yeah. And he has like a bowl of something. It's a conspiracy theory because nobody knows what's in it.
But he's also he's got a shovel in it as well. He's digging
his own grave.
It could be Eminem's grave or it could be his own grave. It depends who you are and who you think wins.
Hold up, trick. You sound like a bitch. Man, if I handle your shit. Mad about something I said in 2012 to you 6 years and a surprise album just to come with a diss. Homie, we get it. We know that you're the greatest rapper alive. Fucking dweeb, all you do is read the dictionary and stay inside. Fuck rap god, I'm the rap devil. Come a bare face with a black shovel like the Armageddon. When the smoke settle, his body next to this instrumental. I'm saying, I'm sick of them sweatsuits and them corny ass. Let's talk about it. I'm sick of you being rich and you still mad. Let's talk about it. Both of us single dads from the Midwest. We can talk about it. Or we can get bully, I'll size up your body and put some white chalk around it. Let's
talk about it. Homie, we get it. We know you're the best, greatest rapper alive.
Facts.
Facts. I'll agree with that. Yeah, he's the GOAT.
Why are you complimenting him?
Yeah.
On a diss track.
See, actually, I want to comment on this. I think, because you're right, because in hip-hop, like, diss raps should be just, like, straight, like, I'm ruining you. So it doesn't make sense to put compliments in there.
Yeah.
But my own philosophies of life, there's good and bad of everyone. So I don't know if I'm entirely against this. Even though you could weaponize it, because he's, like, talking good about, like, if I was Eminem, I'd be like, why are you complimenting me? I think that's how you should treat your friends and family. Or people that you meet in your life, but not someone that you're trying to diss.
Fucking dweeb, all you do is read the dictionary and stay inside.
You're attacking him personally.
Yeah,
now, you know?
Well, you know what, though? All right, it's okay. Like, it's not a great, amazing diss, but it's like, oof.
Yeah, you're right. It's not great, but the line after, though, I actually do kind of like.
I do it too.
Because, fuck the rap god, I'm the rap devil, like the antithesis. I'm the opposite of you. That's cool. That's
antithesis.
A good
antithesis.
Yeah,
okay.
Yeah.
Whoa,
pull up the dictionary.
Whoa, who's staying inside reading the dictionary now?
Come barefaced with a black shovel. Like,
barefaced means me, right? Like, no beard? Is that what barefaced means?
That actually is a connection because he says your beard is weird, yeah. So I'm barefaced. That's actually funny.
Armageddon, when the smoke settles.
So, like, it's gonna be you're destroyed when I'm done.
His body next to this instrumental, I'm saying. Oh, that's cool. He's killing this instrumental.
Oh,
that's
cool. Like, that's here's, cool. Here yeah. lies instrumental. Yeah, here lies Marshall Mathers.
Yeah. I don't put a chorus in it. Don't fucking put a chorus
he's
in
kinda,
it.
He's kind of, he's making it more of like a song rather than a diss rap, you know?
Like, I guess.
You put a chorus in there, it's like, that's not how a diss rap should be. A diss rap should just be like no chorus, just instrumental, beef it out. But
true, but it's like I wouldn't write a song for somebody if I hate them.
Someone is like, I'm not gonna make this catchy for you.
No.
Or I am gonna make this catchy for you, so it gets stuck in your head. So regardless of where you are, it's like in your head. You'll never
imagine
forget
Eminem
it.
Washing dishes like let's
white chalk around it.
He's fucking washing.
And then his like, daughter's like, what are you saying? He's like, nothing. Like, he's like embarrassed about.
Yeah.
It.
He
bro,
got me.
He got you, no. Bro. Machine Gun Kelly knows what he's doing. He's coming in. I'm sick of them sweatsuits and those corny hats because he wears hats. He wore sweatsuits like in concerts and shows and stuff. And he wore a hat for Kamikaze and shit.
For a while.
I thought he was balding at first. And then
sick of you being rich and still mad. Let's talk about it.
Okay.
Fair.
That's
fair.
One thing, one complaint I do have about Eminem. When he goes after the haters, do you feel like, why are you even wasting your time with them? Or do you feel like, no, go for it?
No, it's both. Because it's like, for one, it's good content. Because he comes up with
entertaining.
Yeah, it's super sure. entertaining. And he's like, in my opinion, like a beast when he's mad.
Yeah.
So it's like, cool.
Okay, so fuel the anger, yeah. Spit it out. Okay,
but at
okay.
the same time, it's like, you're on top of the game. Don't waste your time with crumbs. You know what I mean?
Or we could get Gully. I'll size up your body and put some white chalk around it. That's kind of a bar.
It's just kind of bold talk. talking about you're gonna kill somebody and you're coming in with like very soft
his fucking beard's weird
hits. Oh, we can get bullet your size up your body and put some white chalk around it. Let's talk about the fact you're actually black while a rapper that's twice as young as you. Let's call Sway, ask why I can't go up to Shea 45 because of you. Let's ask in a scope how you had Paul Rosenberg trying to shelf me. Still can't cover up the facts. Your last 4 hours is bad as your selfie. Now tell me what you stand for. I know you can't. I think that's hitting his old self again. Old people fucking
that's worse just t- as don't bad take as good selfies. Selfies that's kind of a low ball again. It's kind of like the your beard is weird, like come at him with like I like the
I don't like the way you dress. Okay,
I like like I like the rap god, I'm the rap devil, body next to his instrumental, and then he comes at it with like your last four albums are as bad as your selfie. Not a strong bar.
No.
Okay, I'll be honest though, I do like when he gets serious and he's just like, I guess he's not looking for bars. It's more like Joyner Lucas compared to Logic. Like there's no bars, but he's saying stuff. Like he's saying let's talk about the fact that you blackballed a rapper twice as young as you. Let's call Sway and ask why I can't get on Shade 45 because of you. Did he like call him to? Because I know
Sway in the Morning.
Yeah, and yeah. Eminem are close, right?
Yeah. Yeah, I guess I don't know what happened there specifically, but I think Sway won't let him on because of what he said about Haley's daughter. Or fucking Haley's daughter. Haley.
Haley's his daughter. She's got a kid now? That's crazy. Part. Let's ask Interscope, like how you had Paul Rosenberg trying to shelf me. Like, that's kind of hard. You're like kind of coming against me. Like, you're stopping my career from growing. This is what I think he's trying to say. Is like you've been doing all like covering up all these avenues, trying to stop me from growing as an artist. Because I know he says something about like you're trying to keep food out of my daughter's mouth or something.
Mm.
That's kind of hard. All these things that I was like,
and it was like all that, and then his next line is like all that still can't cover up the fact that your last four albums are terrible. What was his four albums? But I don't. This came out before Music to be Murdered By.
Oh, so. You're right. Okay, so it'd be Kamikaze. Revival, Marshall Mathers LP, and then Recovery. Okay, so yeah, Recovery. He's saying Recovery's bad. I liked
Recovery. Yo, I'm not afraid. That was hard, bro.
That was like Eminem reinventing himself as well. Because before that, he put out Relapse, and he was known as like the edgy rapper, you know. And then he had like the drug stuff. Bro. He went to rehab, came out with Relapse. No one liked Relapse because he had Slim Shady on there, and he was just. I felt he was being offensive for offensive sake. Like, mm-hmm. He wasn't really putting meaning behind it. And then he comes out with
Recovery.
That's a great album. I loved Recovery.
He got a lot of, like, the majority on his side because of Recovery.
Yeah. I feel like that almost reinvented him in a way. Like, he absolutely. Was famous in the 2000s, like, 2001, 2002. Then he kind of dipped a little with Encore and Relapse. And then boomed again with Recovery. Recovery
came hard.
Kamikaze, I don't know if it did that well.
Came hard. I love Kamikaze. And your last four albums are as bad as your selfie.
He's including Recovery.
In yeah.
Do not agree. Recovery was good.
Kamikaze was also good. Still can't cover up the facts. Your last four albums are bad as your selfie. Now tell me, what do you stand for? What? I know you can't stand yourself. Trying to be the old you so bad you stand yourself. That might be my favorite line, bro. That's nasty.
That's a bar, bro. Says you can't stand yourself, so you stand yourself. Like those go to you stand yourself, you stand yourself.
Oh, what do you stand for? You can't stand yourself.
Oh! And then he says trying to be the old you so bad that you stand yourself, bro.
Like, crazy. That's, using something he like a song he wrote, again. A word he made, and then using it against him. That's crazy.
Using his song against him.
See that? More of that. More of that. That's how that's how you kill the king.
Bro. That's I think it's getting stronger as it's going on. Trying to be the old you so bad you stand yourself. Let's leave all the beef in the 50. After pushing 50. Why you claiming I'ma call Puff when you the one that called Diddy? Then you went and called Jimmy. The cops called me in the morning. They told me you mad about a tweet. You wanted me to say sorry. I swear to God I ain't believe him. Please say it ain't so. The big bad bully of the rap game can't take a fucking joke. Oh, you want some fucking smoke, but not literally you'll choke. Yeah, I'll acknowledge you're the GOAT, but I'm the gunner, bitch, I got you in the scope. Don't have a heart attack now. Somebody help your mans up. Knees weak or old age. The real Slim Shady can't stand up.
That's so far! Yes.
That's
yes.
More of that.
So far, I've noticed three references. Rap God, Rap Devil. You're standing yourself.
Standing yourself.
The real Slim Shady can't stand up.
Can't stand up. And then also the knees weak of old age. Like, that could be a reference to Lose Yourself.
Yeah,
like, knees weak, arms are sweat.
No, wait. Vomit on the sweater already.
Going after his age, bro. That's...
These
are low blows, man.
There's a whole section. Yeah, he is actually going hard on
age. Yeah, yeah.
Below the belt shots.
Below the belt shots, yeah. You're old... Also, leave the beefing to 50, because 50
is such a troll.
50 is a troll, yeah. But he had the, going back to Ja Rule.
Yeah, Ja Rule.
He had a beef with Ja Rule. So he's like, leaving the, I actually think that's kind of a bar too. Leave the beefing to 50, and you're pushing 50. Like, you're almost 50 years old, yeah.
There's a whole section there. Please. Where we need to do some research, unless you know, because you seem to fucking know random shit.
Oh, the Jimmy thing?
Yeah. What's it called? You claiming that I'm a call Puff.
Like Puff
Daddy.
You're
the one that called Diddy. What does that? What does any of that have to do anything with anything?
I guess Machine Gun Kelly's like, you're saying that I'm gonna be calling Diddy scared? Like, you're the one who called Diddy. And then you went and called Jimmy. I don't know who Jimmy is.
Jimmy Fallon?
They call... You know Eminem doesn't do talk shows. He doesn't do that. P. Diddy... produces Machine Gun Kelly. That's actually Dr. Dre did Eminem. P. Diddy produced Machine Gun Kelly. Like, they're under each other's record labels.
Right.
So I guess Eminem called P. Diddy and was like, yo, watch your boy. Like, he's commenting on my daughter. They all had a conference call and they called Machine Gun Kelly and were like, yo, stop.
If you're produced under like Dre or fucking P. Diddy or whatever, wouldn't you have to like kind of be like, yo, this is what I'm like, here's what I'm thinking. Should I do this?
Yeah,
like, what do you think? And they all were like, P. Diddy was like, fuck yeah, that was hard, do it. Like,
oh, you might have a point there. P. Diddy might be in on this, too.
Oh.
Do they have a beef?
They probably do now.
Eminem. Saying you were mad about a tweet, say it ain't so, the big bad bully of the rap game can't take a fucking joke. Bro.
Yeah, it was not a joke, though.
You're like making him mad. Have you noticed the rhyming scheme in the song so far? This might be kind of, okay, I'll admit this is the weakest of the song that I've seen so far. So obviously there were some stronger ones, but he has a line here. He says, oh, you're looking for the fucking smoke, but not literally, you'll choke. Like, smoke and choke, that's like, I've heard that before. They're not like...
Hard hitting.
I think it was during the Friday Night Cypher video. You were like, I like it when artists are rhyming multiple syllable word, like hand missing.
Yeah.
Animal ambition.
Right, right.
You're looking for the smoke, but not literally, you'll choke. And that's also one syllable.
Yeah,
smoke,
weak.
Choke.
You're right. It's weak.
Yeah. But he's got
someone
some
on their
bars.
First day of rapping could come up with that shit. You're right.
But then again, he does the thing you're talking about where I'll acknowledge you're the GOAT, but I'm the gunner, bitch. I got you in the scope. Like, you're the GOAT, but I'm here to, like, take you out. I'm the GOAT now. Like, I'm going to replace you.
Mm-hmm. We'll I would have, if I was him in this situation, I'm not a rapper or anything, but if I was him in this situation, I wouldn't have used GOAT. I would have done something with game. Like, because you know how game is,
you've
like...
You killed it in the game.
Yeah, you killed it in the game. Now I'm going to kill the game. Like, you know how, like, if you're hunting, game?
Ah, okay.
If he's the gunner, then he's hunting game. And he's like, you know? Like, I would have done something with that. This is off the fucking top, so it's like...
Yeah, there are ways he could have said all this without saying, like, oh, you're the GOAT.
You're the
like,
best.
I'm acknowledging that you're the best. Yeah, you can't compliment the person on a diss rap, you know?
Like, how are you going to suck his dick and then kill him? Like...
Oh, and then I like how he's touching on... Machine Gun Kelly being like an Eminem fan back in the day. Like, he was like, I looked up to you. You were my idol. Because then he says the big bad bully of the rap game can't take a fucking joke. It's more like, oh my god, like, unbelievable. I've been let down. Like,
oh,
I thought you were this, like, crazy.
Super bad guy.
Yeah, bad, and then now you're like,
it, yeah.
You're like, got double standards. Because actually, Eminem does have double standards with women when it comes to his daughters. Because he shit talks women
all the time.
But when it comes to his daughters, he's like, nah, cut that shit out. Don't have a heart attack now? Is that like an old age thing as well?
It is. Yeah. How many is that? We should have a counter going.
Yeah, actually. Whoever's editing these, put like a little counter here.
Yeah, yeah. How many old man jokes? That now. Somebody help your man's up. Knees weak or old age. The real Slim Shady can't stand up. I'm sick of them sweatsuits and them corny hats. Let's talk about it.
Hello, Marshall. My name's Colson. You should go back to recovery. I know your ego is hurting just knowing that all of your fans discovered me.
There's a hole. You left an opening and I found it, you motherfucker. Recovery. He said his last four albums were trash. You should go back to recovery. But what do you mean go back to recovery if that was in one of the last four albums? You dog water bastard. There is an opening and you are gonna get knocked out here.
But I do like the instrumental there where he's like, hello, Marshall, my name's Colson. And then the music drops out and you're like, you should go back to recovery. And then it goes back again. No production.
You know what?
Production.
Yeah. It's cool how it's like, you know how like in AA, never been in AA, but it's like in Alcoholics Anonymous, they're like introduce themselves like, hi, my name's whatever the fuck.
You should go back to recovery.
You should go back to recovery.
Oh,
yeah.
Good catch. Because that's actually, it could be a triple because he said, you should go back to recovery, meaning the album or recovery, like go back to when you were just getting off drugs, you're cleaning yourself up. Like, go back to that. So that's like, along with what you said, that's a triple.
Oh.
So that's actually dope.
He shot a three, but his fucking foot was over the line, so it only counts as 2 points.
It's a foul line.
Hello, Marshall. My name's Colson. You should go back to recovery. I know your ego is hurting just knowing that all of your fans discovered me. Like, damn, he a younger me. Except he dresses better and I'm ugly. Always making fun of me. Stop all the thuggery. Marshall, you living in luxury. Look what you done to me. Dropped an album just because of me. Damn, you in love with me. You got money, but I'm hungry. I like it this, but you won't say them lyrics out in front of me. Shout out to every rapper that's a fun to me. Know that I'll never do you like the fuckery. Still bitter after everyone loves you. Pull that wedgie out your dungarees. I gotta respect the OGs. And I know most of them personally. But you just a bully acting like a baby, so I gotta read you a nursery. I'm the ghost of the future, and you just have the needs of Scrooge. I said I'm flexed, anyone can get it. I ain't know it will be you.
Okay, that might be my favorite verse.
So oh, yeah? Far.
That might be my favorite verse. Do you not agree?
I mean, it's...
Of the whole song? Because he says, hello, Marshall, my name's Colson, you should go back to recovery. And then he takes recovery, and then starts rhyming with it. And I was trying to keep track of how many times he rhymes recovery.
Oh my god.
I actually lost track. I know your ego is hurting just knowing that all of your fans discovered me. He like Damien younger me. Except he dresses better and I'm ugly.
Ugly,
like
he actually does the
the Eminem thing where you take a 2-syllable word and stretch it into a 3-syllable word.
Ugly.
Luxury. Always making fun of me. Stop the all the thuggery.
Oh
Marshall,
god.
You're living in luxury. Look what you've done to me. Dropped an album just because of me. Damn, you in love with me. I got money, but I'm hungry. He does it again. Like,
oh my god. Lyrics
I like the
out
diss,
in front
but,
of me.
I like the diss, but you won't have lyrics out in front of me. Shout out to every rapper that's up under me. Know you that I'll never do you like this fuckery. He takes the rhyme and actually says something with it there too. I may not
rate that. You know what? I'll take that back. Yeah, I didn't say it was a bad verse.
No, you did.
No, you're right.
No, this is pretty, for all intents and purposes, to be completely fair, this is a good verse.
Solid verse. You're right. I just wish he would like change his flow up at least once.
It went a little too far. That's actually fair. Shout out to every rapper that's under me. I won't do you like this fuckery. Like, as in, if you're under me, I'm not gonna treat you the way Eminem's, from his point of view, treating someone that's under him. Like, he's expressing his thoughts, and I actually feel like he's expressing them pretty well.
Yeah, because he thinks that he is underneath Eminem, and he's like,
Eminem's
treating
picking
me
on
like
me.
Shit.
Yeah, but I'll never treat you like shit. Like, he's saying something with it, so that's actually dope.
He's like, damn, he a younger me, except he dresses better, and I'm ugly. Because he's saying that from the perspective of Eminem. He's saying that as if Eminem was saying it. He's like, damn, he a younger me.
Except he dresses better, and I'm ugly. Yeah.
So it's like, cool that never happened, but it's like...
yeah. Again, like what you said, like a schoolyard bully, where like mimicry?
I know what you are, but what am I?
Yeah.
Kind of childish. You're right. He is kind of petty.
It is like, if you're trying to get someone mad, you kind of pretend like you're misunderstanding their meaning. So when he says like, dropped him an album just because of me, damn, you're in love with me. Like, I can imagine that's like a good line to get someone mad in a diss rap, I guess.
I like the diss, but you won't say them lyrics out in front of me.
Like,
again, stop complimenting me.
I gotta respect the OGs, and I know most of them personally, but you're just a bully acting like a baby. I gotta read you a nursery. Eminem's coming at you, bro. Like, you're asking to get just riddled with bullets. Like,
I'm the ghost of the future, and you're just Ebenezer Scrooge. Add that to the tally, wherever it ends up being.
Oh, Ebenezer Scrooge, right, because he's old. Like, I'm the young one, you're the old one. Like, I'm telling you about what's coming. Like, your death is coming. I know all your fans discovered me. That's kind of a bar. I don't think it's true, but...
I sat on flex, anybody could get it. I know it'd be you! Yo, that was hard. I like that one. Okay, you're right.
That's my favorite. That's the best verse of the song so far.
You're right, though. It is getting better as it keeps going, so it might just... keep getting better.
I gotta respect the OGs, and I know most of them personally. But you just a bully acting like a baby, so I gotta read you a nursery. I'm the ghost of the future, and you just have the needs of Scrooge. I said I'm flexed, anyone can get it. I ain't know it will be you. I'm sick of them sweatsuits and corny hats. Let's talk about it. Sick of you being rich and you're still mad. Let's talk about it. All of us sing bass from the Midwest. We can talk about it, or we can get bully your size up your body and put some white chalk around it. Hey.
Ride a shoddy cause I got a road, it's dope. It's a fast road when your idols become your rivals. Yeah. Never hesitate to say it to your face. I'm an asshole.
Oh my God,
fuck you. We know you get nervous, rabbit. I see mama spaghetti all over your sweater. I wish you would lose yourself in the record. But you made a decade ago, they were better. According to them, you're a national treasure. To me, you're as soft as a feather. The type to be scared to ask Rihanna for a number. Just hold her umbrella, Ella, Ella. Okay, Oscar the Grouch, chill on the couch. You got an Oscar, damn. Can anyone else get some food in their mouth?
Bro, hold it. That was pretty good, too.
I'm actually excited to hear Eminem's response. This is entertaining as fuck. This is what I'm here for, man.
If you're gonna make a diss track towards Eminem, you make cannot hold any punches. You make cannot hold anything, bro. Because if you're gonna even, like, take into the fact that you're gonna make a diss track towards Eminem, you have to go with everything you got, bro. This is the king we're talking about. You have to say everything.
His fucking role in 8 Mile
was
B-Rabbit.
B-Rabbit.
So he's saying, we know you're nervous, Rabbit. I see mom's spaghetti all over your sweater.
Mm-hmm. I wish you would lose yourself on the records. That's the lose yourself.
Lose yourself, yeah.
Music, come on, but you want it. You never can.
Knees weak, arms are heavy. Rabbit, mom's spaghetti, lose yourself. All three of those lines connect.
Yeah.
This one, though, because Eminem and Rihanna were, like, close. Like,
yeah.
They made Love the Way You Lie. They made
Love the Way You Lie Part 2.
Yeah. They made The Monster, and they even went on a tour together. It's too scared to ask Rihanna for her number. Just hold her umbrella, Ella, Ella.
Yeah.
You know those, like, a dude who's, like, infatuated by a girl and they're just, like, doing stuff for them, but they're too shy to ask them anything? Her...
Simp! We got ourselves a simp!
And then he says, okay, Oscar the Grouch, sit on the couch. You got an Oscar. Like, Oscar the Grouch, but then Oscar, like, the award.
Oh, man.
Eminem won an Oscar. First rapper to rap song to win an Oscar for Lose Yourself. So that actually connects back to the Lose Yourself, like, the... That whole thing is, like, lose yourself.
I don't get it. It's almost like this entire paragraph, this part here. It's like giving credit to Eminem again.
Oh, you got an
Oscar. Stop sucking his dick. And then another one for the tally on old jokes. Oscar the Grouch.
Can anyone else get some food in their mouth? Bro, that actually might be taken from Lucky You. Where Eminem's talking about, like, you think I'm filled up, like, past the plate. He's coming strong, though. Like you said, you gotta don't pull any punches.
Don't pull any punches.
When you go for the king, you kill him.
You got an Oscar, damn. Can anyone else get some food in their mouth for real? They made a movie about you. You and everybody's top 10. You're not getting better with time. It's fine. Eminem, put down a pen. Or write an apology. Or with a simple fact, you wear a dish to acknowledge me. I am the prodigy. How could I even look up to you? You ain't as tall as me. 5'8", man. I'm 6'4". 7 punches, hold your head still. Last time you saw 8 Mile was at home on a treadmill.
Oh!
You were named after a candy. I was named after a gangster. And don't be a sucker and take my verse off of Yellow Wolf's album. Thank you. I just want to feed my daughter. You try to stop the money to support her. You the one always talk about the action. Text me to Addy. I'm pulling up scrappy.
Last time you saw 8 Mile was on home on your treadmill.
Yeah.
When you're running.
Yeah.
And then it tells you how far you're going. 8 miles.
that also connects back to the Lose Yourself.
Yes.
Like the Oscar. You got an Oscar. Like, I like the way it bounces. But I like the line, it's fine, Eminem, put down the pen. Because he's always talking about pens.
True, pins and pens.
Stop sucking his dick, because he's saying, like, you're in everybody's top 10.
He's getting so petty with what he's saying. So far he said, I dress better than you, I look better than you, I'm taller than you. Now he's saying, how could I even look up to you? You're not even
that. See, that's actually cool that he took the look up to you, like, as an idol.
Yeah,
but then he made it into a
literal
hype thing. Yeah.
Sense.
7 punches, hold your head still. I wonder why. What does that mean?
Ooh, I got it. Check this out. Imagine it like a cartoon, right? Shorter guy, bigger guy. The big guy's holding their head, and then the little guy's just like, trying to reach. Going back up real quick, I see mama's spaghetti all over your sweater. I wish you would lose yourself in the record. He does a flow there, which Eminem directly disses in The Ringer.
Do you have any idea
how much I hate this choppy flow? Everyone copies, they'll probably know.
We know you get nervous, rabbit. I see mama spaghetti all over your sweater. I wish you would lose yourself in the records that you made a decade ago. They were better recorded.
That was the flow right there.
You're named after a candy, like M&M's. And then
yeah.
I was named after a gangster. That's cool.
Good.
Oh, and then don't be a sucker and take my verse off, like, suckers or candies.
Oh, cool.
So I guess he was supposed to be on Yellow Wolf's album, but then Eminem called Yellow Wolf and was like, because I know they made a song together. So he was like, yo, I'll be on a song with you. Get Machine Gun Kelly off of that shit. Yeah.
Is that what happened?
That's what he's saying. Hey, I don't know what happened. I'm just deciphering the lyrics. I just want to feed my daughter. You're trying to stop the money to support her. That's the line I was talking about earlier. I'm excited to see how he responds to that specifically. Because that's like, I would agree if it's true. Like, mm-hmm. don't be petty like that.
True. If you're so such a family man. You're the one always talking about action. Text me the addy. I'll pull up scrapping. That's pretty sick. You're all talk now. And I'm by my motherfucking self while what's you're paying it? Like millions in security.
That goes that was, back yeah, to the original way, line. Way back. Whoa, okay.
You were named after a candy. I was named after a gangster. And don't be a sucker and take my verse off of Yellow Osama. Thank you.
That was pretty cool. The seven punches. Here's why. 5, 8, 6, 4, 7 punches. 8 mile. That was pretty cool. He's just counting up. You ain't as tall as me. You're 5'8". I'm 6'4". 7 punches. 8 miles.
Good catch.
That was pretty cool.
When he says you're named after a candy, you hear like that, like the ad lib, and then he says I was named after a gangster, and he's like,
yes, I don't hate this. Fuck.
You were named after a candy. I was named after a gangster. And don't be a sucker and take my verse off of Yellow Osama. Thank you. Thank you. I just want to feed my daughter. You try to stop the money to support her. You the one always talk about the action. Text me the addy. I'm pulling up scrapping. And I'm by my fucking self. What's happening? ESC captain, salute me and shoot me. That's what he's gonna have to do to me when he realizes that it ain't shit he can do to me. Everybody always hated me. This isn't anything new to me. Yeah, there's a difference between us. I got all of my shit without Drake producing me. I know you're not used to me. Usually one of your disses should ruin me. A bitch up in Cleveland, everybody quiet this evening. I'm reading the eulogy. Dropping an album called Kamikaze, so that means you kill him. Already fucked one rapper girl this week. Don't make me call Kim.
That's the one, that's the one.
I'm sorry, what?
That's true. Dropped an album called Kamikaze. That means he killed himself. Yeah. Like Kamikaze pilot, like suicide. I already fucked one rapper's girl this week. Don't make me call Kim.
That was a G-Eazy reference. I think G-Eazy. Who the fuck was it?
Oh, because Halsey.
Halsey, that's
Halsey.
What it was.
Yeah, oh, right.
He fucked Halsey. I mean, it didn't.
Already fucked one rapper's girl this week. Don't make me. Oh, I get it. He fucked Halsey?
He fucked Halsey.
They're not together now, though.
I mean, no. G-Eazy and Halsey aren't. But, like, after that. After, like, what's it called? Machine Gun Kelly, they got Halsey. Back together, yeah. G-Eazy and Halsey got back together, then broke up again.
Yeah.
Details.
Everybody always hated me, this ain't nothing new to me. I'm getting mad Eminem vibes, because, like, back in the day, he was like, yo, I'm the kid that everyone hated. Like, I got bullied, I got hated, like, discriminated against. Like, no one liked me, so.
And it worked for him.
Yeah, so maybe, you know what? MGK, do your thing.
But the difference is, he got all his shit, MGK, without Dre producing him. Which
he did it with P. Diddy producing it instead.
In the game, Dre, P. Diddy, Dre.
That's true, Yeah. Dre's up here.
Yeah. How are you going to diss your producer, your own producer?
I also like how the music dropped out. It's like, I did all my shit without Dre producing me, and then it kicked in again. That was cool. So it's like just his vocals. Usually, one of your disses should ruin me.
Again, he's sucking his dick a little bit more.
Bitch, I'm from Cleveland. Everybody quiet this evening. I'm reading a eulogy. That was a hard bar. That's a pretty hard bar. Like, I'm killing him, so I'm also gonna read his, like, Here Lies Marshall Mathers.
Yes. Eminem's ex-girl.
You can tell that, like, I can imagine Eminem listening to this song and being like, fuck. Like,
I have to say something.
Yeah, like, I have to, because there's some hard bars in there that if Eminem didn't respond to it.
It kind of makes him look like a bitch, eh?
Kind of makes him
look like he had nothing to say. Maybe that's a win on its own, just that he got a response from Eminem. Like, that's kind of huge, because it's like...
Shit, you got came at me so hard. Yeah, I had to say something.
Because you know how Eminem said in his one song, he's like...
I mention you, millions of views. You mention me, lose-lose for me, win-win for you.
If you mention him, nothing really fucking happens. But if he mentions you, like, if he talks about you, that means, like, you're important. Like,
yeah,
you actually, like, made an impact a little.
I think MGK is kind of, like, the closest to come to dissing Eminem recent times.
Yeah.
Like, recently. I haven't heard any beef. That was Rap Devil. Honestly, better than I remember.
Better than I thought it would be.
First verse was, not strong, but, like, the middle verse surprised me, and from there, I think the middle verse is still, I think it's still my favorite.
It did get better, though, as you kept, kept going.
Thank you so much for 500 subs. We didn't think we were ever gonna make it to that point.
And we made it in, like, a couple weeks. That's...
Thank you. Welcome to the car. What'd you say? Carpooling?
Carpooling.
We're all carpooling now. Check us out at the next video.